In this video, we're going to go over the types of hormones. Hormones are a range of signaling molecules found in multicellular organisms. They are made in the glands. From there, they are transported throughout the body to specific organs where they regulate bodily functions. There are three groupings of hormones based on their structure: peptide hormones, steroid hormones, and amine hormones. The structure of the hormones, which is the chemical composition of the hormones, affects how the hormone functions. The first group of hormones are the peptide hormones, also known as protein or polypeptide hormones. Peptide hormones are made up of chains of amino acids linked with peptide bonds forming polypeptides, and when even bigger, they form protein hormones. They can range in size from as small as a chain of 3 amino acids to large, complex ones made of hundreds of amino acids. This is the most common hormone type in the human body. Examples of peptide hormones include insulin, glucagon, and oxytocin. Here we can see that the hormone oxytocin is made up of a series of amino acids joined together. Peptide hormones are hydrophilic and water-soluble, but they are also lipophobic, which means they are unable to cross the lipid membrane of cells. Peptide hormones are able to leave the cell they are made in via being packaged into vesicles that can then be excreted through exocytosis. But they are unable to enter a cell on their own. Instead, they bind to receptors on the surface of the cell. This receptor initiates a series of molecules within the cell called secondary messengers in a cascade effect that then initiates cell activity in response to this hormone. This process is called signal transduction. An example of a secondary messenger is cyclic AMP, which is used in the secondary messenger cascade when the hormones, glucagon, and adrenaline bind to receptors on the cell surface. The second group of hormones are the steroid hormones. They are also known as lipid-derived hormones as they come from lipids. Examples of steroid hormones include those related to the reproductive system, such as estrogen, progesterone, and testosterone, as well as those related to the adrenal glands, such as cortisol and aldosterone. Steroid hormones all share the same characteristic steroid backbone, consisting of a four-ring structure of carbon atoms that has three six-carbon rings or cyclohexane rings and one five-carbon ring or cyclopentane ring. Steroid hormones, unlike peptide hormones, are lipophilic, which means they are fat-loving and are able to move through the cell membrane. Once inside the target cell, they bind to receptors within the cell, either in the cytoplasm or nucleus. Once bound to the receptor within the cell, they form an active receptor hormone complex. They act as primary messengers as they are actually doing the signaling within the cell. The activated complex will then move the signal into the nucleus and bind directly to the DNA and work as a transcription factor for gene expression, which is the cellular response to the hormone. The third group of hormones are the amino acid-derived hormones, more specifically, the amino acid tyrosine-derived hormones. All hormones in this group are made from the one amino acid tyrosine. Amino acid-derived hormones do not all have the same properties. There are two groups of hormones that are derived from tyrosine. One group has properties similar to peptide hormones, the other one more similar to steroid hormones. The first grouping of tyrosine-derived hormones are the catecholamines, which are produced in the adrenal glands and the adrenal medulla. An example of a catecholamine hormone is dopamine, which acts as a neurotransmitter playing an important role in signaling a range of human functions, including motor control. Other examples include epinephrine and norepinephrine, which are involved in the flight or fight responses in humans. Catecholamine hormones, like peptide hormones, bind to receptors on the outside of the cell that produce a signaling cascade through secondary messengers inside the cell. The second group of tyrosine-derived hormones are the thyroid hormones, which are produced in the thyroid gland. Examples from this group of tyrosine-derived hormones are thyroxine and triiodothyronine, which are both involved in stimulating the digestive system. Thyroid-produced tyrosine-derived hormones are similar to steroid hormones in that they bind to receptors within the cell and act as primary messengers themselves. Thank you for watching. If you want to support this channel, please subscribe and check out more of my videos.